The Fun Media Group presents Legends of the Arabian Nights, live on Fun 92.7 FM, streaming online at fun927.com. Legends of the Arabian Nights, a look back at some of the most influential nights to ever sit at the round table. Now, live from the Fun Studios in the heart of Arab, with tonight's living legend, here's the voice of the Arabian Nights, Archie Anderson.
Well, time once again for Legends of the Arabian Nights, and our special guest tonight. If Arab has a legend in high school football, it's this guy, because he's native son, graduated from high school here, played sports here, went on to be an Alabama Hall of Fame high school coach. As a matter of fact, National Coach of the Year, I think, a time or two. Lyle Darnell, Arab High School class of 1952. And Coach Darnell, it's a big pleasure to get to talk to you. And boy, anytime we get to talking about old football days in Arab, Alabama, your name always comes up. And Arab is very proud of you and what you've accomplished. But before we get to some of those accomplishments as a coach, I want to go back to your days at Arab, all county in four sports in your junior and senior years. So, needless to say, you enjoyed playing ball during your time here at Arab. Take us back a little bit to those days.
Well, I appreciate that. The reason I enjoyed sports so much in high school was one day I was out trying to pick cotton with a daddy and mother, and he caught me laying on the pallet asleep, and he kicked me in the britches and told me to get up. And I told him, I said, if I ever get out of this cotton patch, I'm going to college, and I'm going to play football and baseball and basketball. I'm not going to do this for a living.
Coach Larry Pod Patterson, and Coach Patterson, of course, as most of you know, Alabama Hall of Famer, my goodness, in the Hall of Fame in Blount County and Marshall County. At Susan Moore, just a legend without question, and it kind of goes back to the first question I asked the man when he came to Arab, was why he came to Arab after such a successful run at Susan Moore and pretty much your stomping grounds and all that kind of jazz. But Coach, you've had a well of a career.
Well, I have, Archie, and like you say, that first question you put to me when I come here, it just floored me. I didn't know what to say, but, you know, it was a good transition, and from Susan Moore to Arab, I always wanted to know if I could coach at a higher level and be successful.
Our special guest today, class of 72, I might say the famous class of 1972, Kim Porch, and a very favorite son of our area, primarily a defensive back for us, and again, all-county defensive most valuable player. Coach Buster Gross is quoted as saying you were the best defensive back he ever coached. That had to give you a little twang to hear that.
It did. I always appreciated Coach Gross, and again, he was just a great coach, great motivator. I was very honored and humbled when he said that, because I know he'd coached some pretty decent players, and he was a kind of a really good player himself, and I think he maybe saw some of my personalities in him that was some of his, and he liked me for that, maybe.
How tough was it in 66? I mean, you guys had won a national championship the year before, didn't have a perfect record that year, come back and you know, roll the table, do the whole bit, 11-0, I think it was, and get passed over. That had to be tough.
Yes, it was. And Coach Bryant always said that was one of his better football teams. But Notre Dame and Michigan State, they were undefeated that year, but they played and played to a 10-10 tie.
Well, Coach, you did have some really, really wonderful years. What do you think was the secret to the junior high program, regardless of what was happening on down the road? And we had some good high school years, of course, but it seemed like the junior high program was always doing well. What was the secret?
Well, there again, Coach Trimble came in after Coach Gross left and went to Emma Sampson, and I learned a lot from him. I still remember Roz and Legal. He may not believe this, but up to the time I quit coaching, I still use that. As a matter of fact, when we had our first meeting, he wrote Roz and Leo up on the board, and I thought he was talking about a man and a woman. I had never heard of Roz and Leo.
Anything stand out in particular, any game in particular that stands out in your memory, Mark?
Absolutely. You know, well, so many of them. Gosh, our senior year, we beat Hartsell. We pretty much dominated them, and that was a big deal. Hartsell has always had, you know, what, 120 guys standing over there on their sidelines. It looked like University of Alabama, and they had dominated everybody for several years leading up to that. So we beat them midway through the season, and, man, that was fantastic.
Marty McDonald, Arab High School class of 1994, a legend of the Arabian Nights.